How to fix error establishing a database connection in WordPress. In this video session, we're going to explore this rather common issue operating a WordPress site. And we're going to understand many different ways as to why this could be happening. Now, I manage WordPress site, and I manage many different WordPress sites as well for valued clients. And often we end up seeing this error establishing a database connection. That means my website right now is down. So the first thing to do, obviously, is we don't be alarmed, because this could just as well be nothing to do with your WordPress site. It could be to do with your web hosting account. It could be that the server is being rebooted, updated, and so on. So the first thing that I do is check with the web hosting. Most modern web hosts will tell you if there are any maintenance happening. As we can see, database server, in my example, it's MySQL, it's active. So right now, I should be saying to myself, okay, you know what? The database of the server is all working. Now, why am I still seeing this error establishing a database connection? Next thing to do is do this. Let's go back to our web hosting account and press on databases. What we need to do here is actually smart before we even dive to troubleshoot this database issue. And that would be smart for us to press on phpMyAdmin to see if we can actually log in to our phpMyAdmin, because your WordPress site resides in a database. So in this example, I know for a fact that, you know what? Even if this network status is showing active, that means there is no problem with the database server, I can see there is something happening with the server, database server, because when I press on phpMyAdmin, it should actually automatically log me in to my database, but it's not doing that. It's telling me to log in manually. And here it says cannot log in to my SQL server. So from my end, I actually can't do anything at this stage, but wait till the database server comes back online. Now, from experience, I should be waiting at least 5 to 10 minutes for this particular setup. Because after that, if I still can't log into my phpMyAdmin, that means my web hosting account needs to be contacted at this moment, because from their end, everything seems okay. And yet from my end, I just can't log in to my WordPress site. Make sense? So what should I do? Well, as I've said, I should wait 5-10 minutes, but while waiting, I'm actually going to show you what else you can do to double check everything, knowing at this moment, if you can't log into phpMyAdmin, and your web hosting account is showing network status for database server is all active and all up, then what else can we do? As I've said, at this moment for my setup, I can't do anything. I can press on databases and actually go to this particular one here. Because here I have my database name, I have a user for that database, so I can triple check everything to see, you know what, is everything working there? Do I have the database in my web host? Is all okay in this department? And do I have a user who can access that database? In my example, yes, I can. Because I know what the issue is. It's got nothing to do from my end. So another smart troubleshooting option is you go to file manager, press on file manager, press on document root for your website, and press on go. Here there is a file under public underscore html and wp-config. I can right click, download the file so I have a backup. I can then right click and press on edit. I'm not going to do that because it contains sensitive information, and yet I'm going to show you my local copy of the same file. wp-config file looks like this. It will contain your database name, user of that database, and the password. So what you want to do at this moment is you can double check to see, does wp-config file exists on your server, which it should because you haven't deleted it, right? What if this file is not here? Then I am afraid you need to get a hold of a backup, or else without this file, WordPress won't work. So as troubleshooting issue, then you can triple check everything to see, you know what, does everything match? Does the database name match? Does the username for that database match? Is the password correct? Yeah, if it is, then you know this file is all good to go. So that means you can avoid this troubleshooting issue as well. So once again, I waited for a little while now. I think I can press on databases and revisit phpMyAdmin. Let's see if it's going to redirect me. Now, I know without doing anything, I can refresh my website, my WordPress site, and it should come back live now, as you can see. So therefore, to fix error establishing a database connection, don't go and straight away start changing things or be alarmed. First thing to do, as I've said at the beginning, is check network status of your web server. In my example, it was active. At that moment, you may think, well, you know what? My WordPress site is down. It just can't connect to the database, even after you check the network status to be okay. The next thing that you should be doing is going to phpMyAdmin and press on that to see if you actually can log in. While here, to make this video worthwhile for you, you can press on your database name of your phpMyAdmin. You can go to, you can select all, check all the tables. With selected tables, you can press on optimize table. Let's do that. phpMyAdmin, for most, in fact 99% of the setups that I've seen, you'll be able to select all the tables, check all, and make sure you only select optimize table. Nothing else here. Listen, don't drop the table or else you'll lose your website. Now, before you even do this, it's actually smart then to press on export and make a copy, as in backup of your database. I know I went a little bit stray at this moment. Error establishing a database connection. You need to be able to see your database, and you can do that through phpMyAdmin, okay? And after that, if you can't see this, then you know what, your WordPress site can't connect to your database. That means the next part for troubleshooting would be for you to triple check wp-config.php file to make sure everything there matches with the correct details for your WordPress database. If all is good there and you've done all these troubleshooting issues and you still can't connect to your website, then the next thing that you can do, in fact, the only thing that you can do, is contact your web hosting provider. and then raise a support ticket, because they will be able to then inform you as to why your WordPress site can't establish a database connection. Apart from that, we really can't do anything. But once you follow these insights and make them within your knowledge when you're managing your WordPress site, then you'll be better informed and actually not be alarmed with this issue, because it's going to happen for any WordPress site. It's just the nature of managing websites. And ideally, you don't want your website to be down for a long time. So that means after you follow all these insights and you still can't access your website, you have to ring the web hosting service provider, because you're paying for their services. At the end of the day, that's how we fix error establishing a database connection. Once again, it will 75% of the time, it will be to do with your web server, you know, doing a maintenance or an upgrade or a reboot, rebooting the servers and so on. That will be the case for 99% of the time, okay? I thank you very much once again for learning with me. If you benefited from this video session, please do give it a like and share it. And I'll talk with you in the next video session.